Hey Pixels, welcome back to Arena TV and welcome to a new decade. Yay! So I really want to talk about my 2020 New Year's resolutions, it being a new decade and everything. But before that, I want to do a little review of 2019 because I think it's really good to pat yourself on the back sometimes. So here it is, my five proudest moments of 2019. My first one is winning Vogue Women of the Year for Vogue Japan. I got to fly out to Japan for it. It was my first ever award ceremony that I was ever actually winning something. I was next to these incredible people who were also being awarded. There was about 10 of us, one of which was Marie Kondo.
I love her so much.
Oh my god. I met her and I told her that she's literally changed the way I fold my clothes. And she took me by both hands and said, "Thank you so much for saying that." Talked for like 30 minutes backstage and it was gorgeous. She's a bit like Mother Teresa. She's just like so nice. I also got to chat with Ai Tominaga, who is this incredible supermodel. I used to draw her in art class. Just these really iconic people from Japan who are doing incredible work. Being standing next to them. Hello, imposter syndrome. I was freaking out. Okay, I'm just gonna have to own it. Own it. Just keep it together. It was a really in and out situation because I got there the night before, had a whole day of prep, and there was like all this press stuff that we had to do and rehearsals, and then we left like the next morning. So I was so tired, and then when I looked back at the footage, there's like little clips of me like fully zoning out on stage. I'm just like transcending like. And my mum, who was there, and she was so proud, bless her, but she was even like, "Babe, you were like zoning out, like you need to wake up, wake up, wake up." By the way, if you don't know Mama Sawayama, she is so iconic. Also just like the wildest, like 60-year-old at the moment. She's just living her best life. Which then leads on to my second biggest accomplishment of 2019, which was the STFU release. I actually got off the plane from Japan, and in that hour, the video was dropping. I was just that person on the plane that was just not getting off like quick enough because I was just like on my phone. I was initially really nervous about releasing STFU. It's a very different sound.
The demons come out.
It's been a while since I released anything. Who knows if anyone cares about me anymore. With my new single, with the new label. But then it went amazingly. Also filming the whole video and recording the music, which by the way, I have made videos for and it's underneath. I can put it in the card here. It kind of gave me a lot of confidence. You know, it really like spurred me on to just do what I want with the music. So my third biggest accomplishment of 2019 is signing with Dirty Hit. They are an iconic label, not only for 1975, but Wolf Alice. Fun fact, Theo Ellis from Wolf Alice used to be in a band that I was in during sixth form, so it's really weird that I'm now like signing to his label. The universe. And with their help, I was able to finish my album because honestly, I was getting to a point where I was like, I've been working on this for 2 years. I literally can't be bothered with this anymore. Like, I don't know how I can finish it. And then they came on board and then everything got a lot better. So I'm really excited and 2020 is gonna be a big year. The fourth one is the Charlie XCX tour. So obviously I've known about Charlie XCX since I was a teenager. She started off on MySpace and I've watched her grow into this incredible alternative pop queen. When she asked me to support her, I was like, oh my God, what? She was so lovely in the whole process. Her team was so lovely playing at Brixton Academy and actually being able to go to like Glasgow, Birmingham, Manchester was incredible because I've never played in those places and I can't wait to come back to those places maybe. Playing alongside Brooke Candy and Christine and the Queens, what? In Brixton was insane. Thank you, Charlie, for giving me that amazing memory. And my fifth one was my Vegas trip for my birthday. My best friend Chester, who lives in LA, organized this incredible trip for me and five friends. And we did a road trip from LA to Vegas, driving through these deserts. And then we got there and wow. What did happen? There were pool cabanas, shows, we went to Cirque du Soleil, casinos, food. It was like a blur and I think Vegas does that to you. But one of my highlights was Magic Mike. I don't even know what to say about it. Basically, I told Chester, don't tell anyone that it's my birthday because I'm knowing what's gonna happen. And then Chester's like, yeah, sure, I'm not gonna tell anyone. And then I get there and he'd obviously told all the cast members that it was my birthday. So yeah, this happened. About five times. To explain the clip, I'm wearing a long dress and flip-flops because I thought it was gonna be chill and everyone else is like in these like super like amazing dresses and like high heels and like glam and I'm there literally like poolside, like Havaiana flip-flops and this really long dress and it was, anyway, it was a logistical nightmare, let's just put it that way.
Oh my God!
So that sums up my 2019. Let's talk about 2020. So my biggest resolution this year is to try and sing and play guitar at the same time. Which to most people, if you can sing,
you're giving me a million reasons to let you go.
And you can also play guitar. You think, oh, of course you can do that at the same time, but it's really fucking hard.
Giving me a million reasons, give me a million reasons. And if I just...
And the reason why I want to do that is because perhaps there's a song on the album that would work really well if I picked up an acoustic guitar on stage.
On stage.
And then sang it with you guys on tour.
Tour.
Spoiler! My second resolution is that I want to get fit. Because we all know I keep falling over on stage. And I think that that is a lack of core stability. I've tried lots of different things. I've tried yoga, I've tried dance classes, I've tried HIIT classes. But I think this year, I wanna be a runner. I always see people running around London and I'm like, you look really like you're in a lot of pain. But also like, you're having a really peaceful meditative moment right now. London is my hometown and I really want to explore London through running, at the same time getting my lung capacity up so that I can sing on stage without dying. Which actually I have got better at. Here's a clip of me in 2017. And here's a clip of me in 2019. So the progress is there. I just want to keep working at it. When I go on, I want to be... I want to be incredibly fit. Like a machine from city to city, with abs, with strong lungs, with strong vocal labias. That's not what it's called, by the way, but it looks like a labia. And then one time I tweeted about it.
Shit, yeah.
And then Mitski commented back, so I called it Vabia. This is your Vabia. And that is fact. That is what it's called. And my third resolution for 2020 is to become more eco. Last year, I adopted some eco habits. I became aware of A, how much plastic we were using, B, how bad flying and traveling is for the world, C, all these global warming impacts, and D, how much the meat industry contributes to global warming. I stopped buying meat. I will eat meat if someone serves it to me, but at home, I usually eat vegan. It's really weird because I'm still conditioned to think that like meat is a treat, but I've really cut out like 90% of meat and dairy products from my life. And in addition to that, I've really cut down on my use of plastic.
Got my portable straw, which is starting to smell a bit rank, but it folds up and it's a good... It smells like a pub. Actually, it really smells bad.
You know, just trying my best. And it was really glaringly obvious that from what I do, touring is so bad for the environment. So from like the riders, which by the way is like the little catering that you get backstage, it creates a lot of plastic packaging, a lot of plastic waste, a lot of food waste in general, to toiletries, also the carbon emissions that are created from touring, whether you're busing it or you're flying. It's really, really substantial when you consider that there's more than 10 people on tour with you. I'm trying to really think of a way to make it as eco as possible and sustainable as possible. So those are my main three goals for 2020. And to keep myself accountable for them, I'm going to be talking about it in the videos that I do on here. And one of the things I was thinking about doing, and I'd love to hear your opinion on it, is to do a 30-day challenge. Things like the guitar and singing, the running, doing a 30-day challenge where I challenge myself to do something every single day. And I'll make a video about it and you guys can see where I did well and did shit. I might make a fool out of myself, probably. Let me know what you guys think. 2020 is gonna be such a huge year. We've got
albums
and we also have tour, and we're gonna have a load of stuff on Rena TV. I've received amazing comments from you guys from the last couple of videos, and you guys clearly love this kind of content, so please let me know any ideas that you think would be really great for a video. Thank you for watching this. This is my roundup for 2019 and my resolutions for 2020. Make sure you guys are subscribed because there's gonna be so much stuff coming out in 2020. I'm so excited to show you.
Let me know what your New Year's resolutions are in the comments below, and make sure you sign the fuckup.co.uk in the description box below, because there might be some fun announcements.
Bye! I also got Forbes 30 under 30, I completely forgot to mention that.
Yeah, you've like not said anything about these awards.
I know,
anywhere.
I like, know. It's because like, it's so weird. I think it is my imposter syndrome, because I just like...
You don't want to talk about your achievements. You
want yeah, because I don't feel
that you've actually made.
Yeah, like music videos. I'm like, yes, like great, yeah. Because that's like effort to product is like proportional, yeah. Whereas like awards are weird.